Another mother nearly lost her son at the hands of a babysitter. Ethen Frerichs shaken so violently he nearly died. Ethen is now 8 years old, his mother teaching new parents a critical lesson. She's also sharing her story with KETV News Watch 7's Michelle Bandur, a story you'll only see on 7.
Hey, Ethen. Can you play with me?
Yeah, Sean.
Okay.
What do I do?
When you imagine a victim of shaken baby syndrome...
Hey, Megan! Come down here!
Would you think of a boy like Ethen Frerichs?
Can you come in?
Yep.
He is one of the most outgoing second graders you'll ever meet, with lots of friends.
Buddy, hug?
Yeah, buddy.
Ethen probably shouldn't be alive. A boy nearly shaken to death by a child care provider when he was just 8 months old. Chief Deputy Sarpy County Attorney Tricia Freeman prosecuted the case in 2003.
I can tell you that there are other cases that I've handled where, you know, the babies have never recovered from a vegetative state.
But at age 2, brain surgery changed Ethan's life. Surgeons disconnected the damaged left hemisphere of Ethan's brain.
His right brain has been able to take over. For the first time, I saw, like, a glimpse of what he can become, and it's just amazing.
In her effort to give Ethan a normal childhood, his mother, Christine, had a revelation herself.
I felt like I could help others. I had a great understanding of what it's like to have a child with disabilities.
While Ethan is learning lessons as a second grader here at Kearney Central Elementary School, his mother is a teacher, teaching parents and babysitters about the effects of shaken baby syndrome on a child. Classes put on by the Buffalo County Child Abuse Prevention Council.
If I can get out and share Ethan's story, then maybe I could prevent one child from being shaken.
Christine says when Ethan was shaken in 2003, statistics show half of the public had never heard of shaken baby syndrome. And sharing her story takes away some of the guilt of leaving her son in the care of Michelle Charles.
I just feel like if I can get out and educate them, then I'm doing my son some justice.
This mother overcomes tragedy, sets aside the anger and resentment, and says Ethan helps her because he is such a sweet, curious, happy boy.
Awesome.
Ethan, though, will carry with him the scars of shaken baby syndrome, a paralyzed right arm, little peripheral vision in his right eye, but this happy-go-lucky 8-year-old is unaware of his disabilities.
I'm gonna be a movie star.
And it does him no good for me to be mad and angry.
And his mother doesn't look back.
I just say that the babysitter shook him and that she damaged part of your brain, but you're an amazing child.
In Kearney, Michelle Bandur, KETV, Newswatch 7.
Okay, we're parked over there.
The woman who shook Ethan was a licensed daycare provider in military housing at Offutt Air Force Base.
A judge initially gave Michelle Charles probation. Sarpy County prosecutors appealed and won. Charles served 2.5 years in prison. She got out in 2008. Court records show Charles admitted shaking Ethan because she was mad at his mother.
There are resources to prevent cases just like this by helping parents and caregivers. Jetty Emmetson Hospital runs the Shaken Baby Task Force. As you can see, there's a 24-hour helpline. You'll also find a link to the group's website through ours at KETV.com. Click As Seen on 7, then look under Tuesday.